Amen. Can you join me to welcome our mommy in the Lord, the number one mommy in Oyo province, Siri? Let's rise up with clap ovation. Let's welcome our mommy. Mommy Priscilla Ashonibare. Mommy, you are welcome. A round of applause. Is that how to clap? Keep jamming your hands.
Praise the Lord. You can have your seats. I know some of us are tired from the evangelism, but give me some few minutes for us to have an interactive section. I call it interactive section because you're going to be giving me some answers. Okay? I would like to thank the children's teachers, the teenagers' teachers, the executives of the children and teens department for giving me this opportunity to come here and be a blessing to us all. I ask that the Holy Spirit is going to speak through me and mold your destinies and make you great and mighty children in the land, in Jesus' name. Oh, you are so tired, you can't say amen. I said in Jesus' name. Okay, let's pray. Holy Spirit, we thank you for sparing our lives to see another lilies among thorns in this year 2020. We ask that you're going to speak to us, you're going to enlighten us, and the grace to be doers of your word, so that the devil will not hijack our future. We receive from you, and we promise right now that we give you all the glory and the praise for everything, in Jesus' name. Amen. Please, I want us to say amen, okay? Don't worry, I'm not going to take too much of your time. The theme for this year says what? Too young to be in love. Too young to be in love. Too young to be in love. Ask a neighbor. Okay, let's do it this way. Ask a neighbor, am I too young to be in love? Was your neighbor winking or smiling when you said it? Okay, tell your neighbor, are you too young to be in love? Ask your neighbor. Ask your neighbor, are you too young to be in love? What kind of answer should I give? Is it a yes or no? I should just give, you know. It's easy now. It's easy to answer the question. You know? Am I too young to be in love? It is a yes. Ah, okay. He said it. What did you say? Am I too young to be in love? Is it a yes or no answer, right? Now, sincerely, if you want to say no. Okay, never mind. Don't let me ask you to raise up your hand so that, you know, people will not shout on you in here. Now, I'm not just going to give a yes or no answer. I want us to talk about it. I'll give us some examples in the Bible. Then we are going to talk about it. Let's open our Bibles to the book of I believe you have your Bible. Okay. Thank you, media people, for helping us. Songs of Solomon, chapter 8, verse 4. Sometimes, because it is long, instead of me saying Song of Solomon, I like to just say SOS. So when I say open your Bibles, you know, this generation, we like acronyms, right? Like LOL. ASAP, things like that, you know, TGIF, something like that, okay. So, if I say open your Bibles with me to SOS, you know what I'm talking about now. So, where all around me. Abi? So we have to really make it clear and zero it down to the one we know our daddies and mommies in the Lord want us to deal with. So you are not too young to be loved, neither are you too young to love someone. Like, let me ask you a question. How many of you love me? Hey, some people are not raising up their hands. Mommy, I didn't need to you see them. Okay, no problem. Anyway, either you love me or not, me, I love you. I love you with all my heart. Okay, so now let's try and put it this way. Am I too young to fall in love? Now we can understand it better. But you are not too young to be loved, because even while you were babies, you were loved. Even while, before you came out of your parents' womb, you were loved. And as soon as you came out, you loved the parents around you. Like when you see a baby, the baby will smile, you know. So a time to love, yes. We can love people.
profound or caring affection towards someone.
Okay, if you have an affection towards someone. Okay. Now, physically. In order for you to be in love, now when you are in love, love should lead to somewhere. You don't just fall in love for falling in love's sake. God has made us as people to fall in love in order for us to end up somewhere. Who knows where? End up where? It's preparation for marriage. Hello? Hello? Come on, see me. I said hello. Now, when you fall in love in preparation for marriage. Now, look at yourself physically. Am I ready to marry? If you're not ready to marry, then are you too young to fall in love? No answer. Are you ready to marry? Okay, you are ready to marry. That's what you are saying. Now, if you're ready to marry, brother, you're ready to marry. Ah, he said no. Now, if physically you are not ready to marry, then are you too young to be in love? And so, I'm hearing mixed answers. Okay, let me come back. If physically, okay, looking at yourself, you are not ready to marry, are you too young to be in love then? Yes or no? Okay. So before you should fall in love, you should be physically mature. Somebody say physically mature. When people look at you, they shouldn't be telling you, are you praying about marriage at all? No, you as a guy, your parents should come and say, have you seen anyone you like around you? Or your parents should come to you as a girl and say, is there any brother disturbing you? That is when physically they know that you are ready. That is number one. How many aspects did I say we should look at to know if you are too young? How many did I say? Four. Okay. And the number one is what? Now the second one is spiritual. Somebody says spiritual. Are you a child of God? Do you know God? Do you know where life is taking you? Do you know how to hear from God? Are you being led of the Holy Spirit already? Do you know how to make decisions with the Holy Spirit guiding you? Because when you are in love, there will be so many decisions you need to make that you cannot make by yourself. Remember we said when you fall in love, you should walk towards marriage, right? I said right? If I'm wrong, tell me wrong, right? Okay. So number two, you should be a child of God, serious with God, following God, hearing from God, knowing how God directs you. That number three. Nobody say number three. What is number one? Number two? Number three is emotionally. Now let me try to give this example for you to understand when I'm talking about emotionally. Many years ago, my husband and I, we had this story about this newly wedded couple. Now, they got wedded because both their parents were rich, so, and you know, they were thinking they're rich, they can manage anything they need. As a matter of fact, they got them a very good house, you know, a nice flat, well furnished for them, so they were married. And God was so merciful, as soon as they got married, the wife, you know, took in and gave birth. So these were two young chaps, you know. But something happened. be emotionally ready to withstand crisis, to be able to cry in the night because you and your spouse, you know, you had an argument, wake up in the morning and go to work as if nothing happened. Hello? I said hello. You should be emotionally ready that when your sisters-in-law will come, they will say so many bad things to you, you'll still be smiling. Many of you are still fighting your siblings. I mean, physical. What did you very much, Pastor. I'm sorry, but it's not actually a question. But I was actually thinking, if it's possible, you already said the seniors, and you're talking about the youths. So I was thinking, it's possible you can actually have this class expanded with we youths. Because I found out that it's very possible a youth is also physically ready, spiritually ready, like, okay, they've been able to work with God to some extent. But emotionally and financially, they might not be ready. And some of them are thinking of relationship. Does that mean it is wrong? So I think we need to treat it also with the youth in general. Thank you.
Okay, she wants us to do the same thing with the youth. Okay, when the youth will call me, I will come and explain. But for our level, we already know where we are, right? Okay. So, are you too young to be in love? Did not agree, because maybe there are some girls that they are eyeing in their class. Hey, are you too young to be in love? Guys, only guys now. Brothers, I'm looking. Brothers, are you too young to be in love? You see, you shall say the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Stretch your hand and say, Father, deliver these guys. Now, to be serious. Ladies, are you too young to be in love? They are the ones listening. You see, they were not listening. You just exposed yourself. The Lord will keep you. Say amen. The Lord will protect you. In the name of Jesus, you will not defile yourselves. You will not bring shame to the name of Jesus. You will not bring shame to your parents. Okay, everybody rise up. Put your hand on your chest. And I want you to make this confession with me. Oh, okay, there's a question. Please sit down. Somebody wants to ask a question. Okay, yeah. Go ahead.
Okay. Let's say now, all the features you gave, you can do it. You are spiritually, physically, financially, and everything shall be okay. So now, let's say you are ready. In your mind, your heart are ready. You can do everything. You can pay your school fees. You can do everything. Now, take care of the girl. So the girl has got to know that she cannot be in love with you. What do we call that?
The girl what? Anyone here in class?
Okay. I said, let's say now you are okay. Spiritually okay. Okay. Physically, you are ready. And you know the financial and everything, sir. Okay. You know, you said you can, you can take care of your partner, right? Let us say, girls of nowadays, if you take care of them, they'll still leave you around the road to another person. So, let's not say, that one, what can we call that one?
Okay. That means...
I don't understand.
Okay. If I'm getting his question, listen, physically you're ready, spiritually you're ready, emotionally you're ready, financially you're ready, and you saw a girl that you thought was ready, and you spent and took everything, took care of her, now discovered that she was not ready. Then she now left you and went to somebody that she thought was ready. And the first thing is, how did you go into that relationship? How? As a child of God, you don't just see somebody and you come, lady, I like you, let's go into a relationship. It is wrong. You will pray. You will receive from God that you should go ahead.
in the Redeemed Christian Church of God that you tell your pastor will pray with you, then your pastor will tell you to go ahead. In that case, it will not be easy to add and drop like Agbero or like Marua. You know, some people are not like Marua. They add, they drop. They add, they drop. Both girls and boys. You go through the normal process in the Redeemed Christian Church of God to save you of the heartaches. You ask the question, you listen. Okay? That is why even among the youth and young adults, we tell them, you don't go into a relationship without informing the authorities of the church, so that nobody will come, I like you, they sleep with you, they drop you, I like you, they sleep with you, and they call themselves Christian brothers. Or some sisters will be going around, relationship with this, they get all your money, then dump you, then go out. No, it is organized in the Redeemed Christian Church of God. Praise the Lord. Okay.
To start a treasure search from that stage, because we need to search one wife and find the good thing and obtain favor. So are we supposed to start the treasure search? Because some people say, if you are not searching at that stage, you might lose the right person. So you need to be on the lookout so that you shine your face very well. When it comes, you will know. All right, so am I supposed to be on the treasure search when I'm already at that stage and shine my face because of people that are coming?
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. How many of us like to go on treasure hunt? Woo! I like to go. Treasure hunt. But as a girl, you don't hunt. You don't go searching. You are the treasure. You are the treasure. And treasure are not found laying on the ground. How many of you have seen diamond as you were going? You just, this is diamond, though, and you pick it. Well, you will dig for it. That is why, let me talk to you, ladies. That is
two parts. So for the first part, I want to ask, what you feel at this age, you feel like or love? What you feel at this age, is it like or love? And then,
okay, what you're feeling now is just an admiration and an affection that should not lead anywhere. It should not be nurtured. But it is normal to have the feeling.
How will you know if it is like?
Okay, now, when it is now a thing that is uncontrolled, it is strong, and it's about to lead you into sin, then it is not normal. It is lust. It is no more love.
Let me say, like, after something like 2 or 3 years, and then you still feel the same.
Okay,
is
after,
that like or love?
No, after 2 or 3 years, you still feel the same for that particular person. Then you have to tell yourself, I'm not ready for this. I will keep it until later. Then give yourself some time. Okay? Don't nurture it. It is what you nurture that grows. So don't nurture. The feelings can come, but don't nurture, don't nurse it. Okay? You have a question.
Praise the Lord. Okay, my question is this. Like, for example, I'm a female. I had a boyfriend. So, we broke up as a result of someone advising me that it's not good and so on. So, the guy now, like, whenever the guy sees me as a gay, like, he ridicules me, like, just say rubbish about me and so on and so on and so on. They ridicule me and so on. So as like girls passing through that kind of stage or that kind of situation, what advice do you have for them? Like, what should they do?
Okay. Now, in the first place, bravo for breaking up. Okay? I celebrate you for breaking up with that guy. And the fact that that guy is not going ahead making a mock of you is confirming to you that he is not ready. He's not mature. The fact that a girl broke up with from you is when you will not be ridiculing the girl around. Then you are not, the guy is not mature. So whenever they do that, you just smile and go and say, thank you Jesus, you have made the right decision. It might be difficult because, you know, at this age, you like to be celebrated, you like to be, you know, to be recognized, you like to get attention, and here you are, somebody is ridiculing you. Don't worry. Future will tell. So just chill and thank God for making the right decision. And if it continues and it's about to affect your self-esteem, please talk to somebody. Because what that person is trying, what they are trying to do is to affect your self-esteem, then to coerce you into going back into the relationship. Don't do that because it is totally wrong. You can see from how the guy and the friends are behaving. Okay?
What to ask this question? Like, I heard it from someone. He said, it's not right for us to date. That dating is not right for a Christian. That we should go into courtship instead. So now, being like, okay, let's say you fell in love, or maybe you like someone, and the person was like, you can start up a relationship from now. But you're like, they said we should not date. But we should wait to courtship. And courtship can just be like 3 months. And there are some guys that they hide their character. You don't know them that much. Like going with them for years. And some, even though you spend like a year with them, you might not be able to know all about them.
Okay.
So this dating or dating, not dating or intimacy.
So what you're trying to say is you need more time to be able to know the guy.
Yes.
Because courtship might be too short a time.
Exactly.
Okay. Now, in the redeemed church of God, the courtship is not shorter than 6 months. Not shorter. And as I said, before you go into it, you must have prayed. You must have involved your parents. Are you with me? Hello? You must have prayed. You must have involved your parents. The people who are elderly, that you respect, who easier for you to break people's heart and go. Break people's heart and go. By the time you are in the marriage, it will be easier for you to get out as well. So don't get yourself numb to people's feelings and, you know, lives that you can just break and walk out like that. It will not pay you. So stay. Wait. Don't rush. There's time for everything. When you are ready, go into courtship, get married, and you will live happily ever after. Amen. I think all the questions are answered. Okay, now. I didn't give you number.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Please, I want to ask at what specific age is suitable for a relationship? And I mean, courtship.
Okay.
As a Christian.
I've already said four things. Check out the four.
Listen, I have another question. We, as in, is it right for you to love somebody at the age of, let's say, 20, 21?
To what?
20, 21.
To love.
To love.
Now, I'm not giving a
20, 21.
I'm not giving a benchmark age. A benchmark age. Okay? Let's go back to the four. Physically, are you ready? Spiritually, are you ready? Emotionally, are you ready? Financially, are you ready? If you are ready, go ahead. But if you are not ready, wait. That is the answer. I'm not giving any age benchmark. But you will know that you are ready when you are really, really ready. Okay, let me be merciful. Where is the lady that wanted to ask a question? She's gone. Okay. Now rise up and let's make this confession. Put your hand on your chest. Say after me. I will wait for the right time. Put your hand on your chest. I will wait for the right time to be in love. I'm not hearing you. I will wait for the right time to be in love. Face me. I will wait for the right time to be in love. I will not let lust destroy my life. I will not let lust destroy my opportunity for love later in life. Holy Spirit, help me and help my spouse to be wherever he or she might be, to wait for the right time to be in love, in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, if you go into love before it is the right time, number one, you'll be sinning against God, like Joseph said, he does not want to. Number two, you'll be sinning against yourself, because you might end up having sex at an early age, and it has been discovered that ladies who end up having sex at an early age and with several partners, they are more at a high risk of having cervical cancer. And men who slept with different girls before getting married, they can infect their wives later with a virus that will cause the cervical cancer. Aborting, apart from the heartaches you will suffer, apart from the shame you will bring to the name of Jesus and your family. Are you too young to be in love? Are you too young to be in love? Say, I will wait for the right time. And the Holy Spirit will help you in Jesus' name.
Let's stretch forth our hands and bless our mommy, that as God has used her for us, that the God of heaven will fill her afresh in the name of Jesus, that anointing over her will not run dry. She will move from glory to glory in the mighty name of Jesus. She continues to be relevant in the face of God in the mighty name of Jesus. Anytime she opens her mouth to talk, the God of heaven will fill it up, and she will be an instrument to raise this generation to the next level in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, mommy. We appreciate you. We thank you for God using you to address us at this hour. May the God of heaven be with you and your family in Jesus' name. Thank you, ma. We love you, ma. Thank you, mommy. Praise the Lord.